morning, so I hope everybody enjoys it. So the youth will start out with a silent night.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I'd like to welcome everyone out this morning. Definitely don't have a pool pit out here. If we have any visitors, I'd like to welcome y'all out as well. Today is Youth Sunday. Normally we have it on the second Sunday, but I asked if we could have it on the third, so that's the reason why we're here for this. This morning's announcements. Today is our youth program. And then tomorrow will be the Young at Heart lunch. They'll be having a tag of food. If you'd like to know what to bring, please see Ms. Lavonda. Also, it'll be this Wednesday night on the 19th, the deadline for the purse for Hope for Women. That'll be the deadline for it. So if y'all like to bring a purse, please do. See, is there anything else here? Please see Carl or Miss Mary Jo if you have any questions about that. Do we have any more announcements?
I had mentioned to the kids that I talked to them, they already have a Salvation Army, we're not going to do that, we're going to be here when we say that, and then, fruit, baskets for the girls that were in the village, and grab the parents from there, and that's the first one. I don't think it's come out, so I think that's going to be able to say that.
All right, do we have any more?
Jamie, I still need some dishes for Ladies Lunch.
All right, please, anybody, Ms. Lavanda still needs some more, dishes brought, please, do that. Do we have any more? Do we have any birthdays or anniversaries? Oh, yeah, we do.
Okay, say it, Carl.
She's same age as I am, I won't mention any numbers.
Right.
At this time, we'll ask everybody if they would please stand if the day being Easter Sunday, if I can have, three young gentlemen to come forward. Miss Amanda, if you will please ask the blessing.
Save our sons and daughters. Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you deliver will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man? Did you know that your baby boy will calm a storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels try? When you've kissed your little baby, then you've kissed the face of God. Did you know that your baby was heaven's perfect time. This sleeping child you're holding is the great I am.
All right, youth. Come up and we'll do the big grand finale here. I think everybody will get a kick out of this. Yeah, music is right here. I'm sorry, hold on guys. I'm getting ahead of myself here. Prayer request. Yeah, just hang out right here.
Morning. Good to be here. I'm happy. See the future. Amen. We are given by God glimpses. Amen. And I hope this is blessed and it grows and our future grows and it can if we believe God. Amen. I love him this morning. I thank him for his many blessings. And we have a lot to pray about. But we ought to be praying with happy hearts and smiles on our faces no matter what we're praying about because God has blessed us today. Amen. And Brother Gary, God holds the future, not man. Amen. And I'm so proud of that. I'm so glad that God has a future. If man had it, he'd mess it up. Amen. He would. So I'm glad that God's in my life. I pray that he's in yours. And if he's not, I pray that you find him before it's everlasting. I love him this morning. I want to pray for everyone who's fighting cancer. Let's pray for Wayne, Carol, Roger. Anybody fighting that fight. We know God can help us. Amen. And we know that he will. We trust him. Amen. And we've had answered prayer. Let's pray believing. God makes the difference, y'all. I love him. Do we have any spoken requests before we go to the Lord in prayer? God bless you. Let's remember that. Anyone else? Let's do it. And they're included in my prayers. I think of you a lot when you go visit them. How wonderful they are to have you for a friend. And how blessed they are. God puts you there for a purpose. Amen. Go ahead. Remember that. Go ahead, eh? Let's love each other and pray for one another. You know what? God wants us to pray one with another. And we can get strength from that. Let's remember. Let's remember Jeff. Amen. Another answer to prayer. Amen. I got a call from Cece, and Charlie hadn't been doing real good. He's mostly sleeping. And the doctor says that's not really good for him all that much. So she wanted us to remember them. Let's pray for Charlie and Cece. Anyone else? Let's remember them. All unspoken. Let's go to the Lord in prayer.
Alrighty, our special song this morning, I know everybody has heard this on the radio. Its origins actually come from a Catholic church. A Christian songwriter wrote another version and changed up the verses, but we've all heard the 12 Days of Christmas, so this is going to be fun to watch, and the band is going to be playing it, and the kids are going to sing each verse. So please, everybody sing along. We're going to have it on the projectors as well, so sing along with us.
Bye. Sometimes we push them real hard, and sometimes we're real mean, but they work hard, and we got a lot of talented kids here, a lot of musicians, a lot of singers, a lot of up-and-coming possible musicians and singers, and thank you to the people that work with them. I'm not musical, so I couldn't do any of that, so let's just give them another round of applause.
Wasn't that good? Woo! I'm so happy I could holler. I might just do that, you know? It's all right to serve God. It's all right to be happy serving God too, amen? Y'all hear me? I'm happy because God has a plan, amen? We are pitiful, but God loves us, and He has a plan for us, amen? And He has a plan for this church, you hear me? We have something to do for God, amen. And we're doing some of it. Let's continue, amen. I love Him this morning, Wayne. These young people just bless my soul to know that they're willing and workable and loving God doing it, amen. I'm not going to preach. Y'all believe that? I am going to turn Brother Jonathan loose here in a minute. But I thank the Lord this morning for His love and His goodness and for our children. Let's support them. Let's do what our part is to help them to grow and to love God in their life. And we get repaid. Amen. God replays us with His love and His mercy and His goodness and the joy of hearing them sing and participate in God's house. I love Him this morning. And I thank Him for His many blessings. And I thank you for coming. Amen. You have a part in this too. Amen. Even if it's just to enjoy the goodness of God. Amen. It's okay to love God. It's okay to have enjoyment doing it. It's okay to be happy serving God. Amen. That's what it's about, is the love of God in our hearts and our life. To be happy to celebrate with God in our life. Amen. Are you ready to celebrate? Brother Johnson, come on. I love God this morning, and I thank Him for His many blessings. Let's give Brother Johnson and the good Lord a good hand. God bless you.
For the Lord this morning. It's a privilege and an honor to be here this morning. I want to say I'm glad that I've got Christmas every day. Amen. I can have Christmas every day. As they were singing about the different things the Lord has given to me, all I can say is amen. It's good to be in the house of the Lord this morning. Brother Sam called us a few weeks ago and asked us to come this way. We've done a lot of pondering and meditating from time to time about what the Lord would have this morning. And I want to read some this morning out of the Christmas story, but I want to lay a foundation for the point this morning, God being my helper. And I want you to just listen to the Word of God this morning and examine it in your life. I'm nothing, can do nothing on my own, but I want to share some things with you from the Word of God that I think will help us this morning. First of all, I want to read a couple of verses in 1 Corinthians chapter 3. Like I said, I just want to lay a foundation this morning in the message. He said in chapter 3 and verse 16, "Know ye not that ye are the temple of God, and that the Spirit of God dwelleth in you? If any man defile the temple of God, him shall God destroy. For the temple of God is holy, which temple ye are." I just want to think on that thought this minute about being the temple of God. We need to realize that us that are born again, that we are where God dwells. The church is not these four walls, but it's within us. We have a responsibility within that this morning. I want to read a couple of verses over in the book of John, St. John's Gospel. I want to read about four verses beginning in chapter 1, verse 1, 2, 3, and verse 14. It said, "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. And the Word was God, the same was in the beginning with God. And all things were made by Him, and without Him was not anything made that was made." Verse 14 says, "And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld His glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth." Now let's go to Luke. Keep all that in mind. Let's go to the book of Luke. I want to begin reading in chapter 1, verse 26. It said, "And the angel said it in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God unto the city of Galilee, named Nazareth, to a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph, of the household of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came in unto her and said, Hail thou that art highly favored, for the Lord is with thee, blessed art thou among women. And when she saw him, she was troubled at his sayings, and cast her in her mind what manner of salutations this should be. And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. Behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb, and shalt bring forth a son, and shalt call his name Jesus. And he shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David. And he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom shall be no end. Then said Mary unto the angel, How shall this be, seeing I know not a man? And the angel answered and said unto her, The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore also that holy thing which thou shalt be which shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God. And behold, thy cousin Elizabeth hath also conceived a son in her old age. This is the sixth month of her which was called barren, for with God nothing shall be impossible. And Mary said, Behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be it unto me according to thy words. And the angel departed from her. Turn with me to chapter 2. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxation was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, every one unto his own city. And Joseph went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, unto Judea, unto the city of David, which was called Bethlehem, because he was of the household and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there was in the same country shepherds abiding in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came unto them, and the glory of the Lord shined round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you, which ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angels a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace and good will toward men. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, as we do humbly come before you one more time, we thank you, Lord, for the day of life that you've given us. Thank you for the opportunity to come back to your house one more time. Thank you, Lord, for the people of God that are gathered here this morning. And God, if there's any here that do not know you in the free pardon of sin this morning, as I trust that they are, Lord, that you would help them to see the need to come, Lord, and to come to know you in the free pardon of sin and the salvation that is in Jesus Christ. Lord, move upon their heart as only you can. And God, show them their lost condition. And God, show them the need for a Savior, and that they would look unto you for that salvation this morning. For it's only in the name of Jesus that we have any hope. We thank you, Lord, for coming and dying upon us. Help us, O Lord, to look into the thought that you've given us this morning. God, I pray that you would help us, God, to go home a different way than we came this morning. God, a more glorious way, and God, a more thoughtful way. God, help us to make the room in our lives. For it's in Jesus' name I pray. Amen. passage of scripture this morning, I told you I wanted to lay a foundation for the message this morning. We realized that the Word of God is Jesus Christ. This morning we read in the book of John, you can study that out in the first chapter, about how that Jesus was the Word of God. He is the Word of God today. He is this right here. He was this right here in fleshly form. He is the Word of God. This Word of God dispels all of His glory. We can go to that Word. It's all in the same. This morning He has revealed Himself to us upon these pages this morning. But He came through the story that I read you this morning through a virgin unto us this morning. We realize that He has come this morning not only as a little child, but He did grow up and He has become a Savior of the world. He has brought good tidings toward all men this morning. Why? Because we within ourselves are nothing good. The Bible describes us as worthless. Amen. Nothing before the Lord. We realize that our righteousness is not good enough for God this morning, the very best that we can do. We realize that we have a condition, a sickness that we cannot cure within ourselves. We realize that there had to be a sacrifice that would please the wrath of God this morning. And the Bible said that it pleased God to bruise His own Son, to set His own Son to be the sacrifice. You can read in the Bible that tells us that Jesus Christ was the Lamb of God, slain from the foundation of the world. But He was to be sent in through a pure and a holy form this morning. Let me just say this morning and I'll move on. You cannot be a Christian if you cannot believe in a virgin birth this morning. I want you to know this morning, without it this morning, it would all be in vain. But if you study it out, my friends, it happened just the way it's recorded. Yeah. There's plenty of proof. They keep trying to prove it wrong, Brother Sam, and they just keep proving it truth. Amen. I'm thankful for scientists, whether they believe or not, because the more they try to prove God wrong, the more they prove Him right. I'm thankful this morning that you can't prove my God wrong. Why? Because He made right this morning.
Amen. Amen.
We realize this morning that He has brought good tidings toward us. I'm going to get down to the thought in a minute. But I want us to realize this morning that as I said and read over there in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 3 and verse 16, we are the temple of God this morning, and it's up to us to allow God to come in and dwell within us. The morning that I got saved, I had to open up my heart into my life and allow God to come in and dwell with us. Now we're coming up on what we call Christmas. We're celebrating the gift that God has sent us, and it's up to us to open up our heart and to make time for God, amen, and to make preparations to serve God. How do we serve God this morning? The Bible teaches me that if I'm going to serve God and to show the love of God, I have got to serve you this morning. If we are going to serve God, we do it by serving one another this morning. And I want to get down to the verse of Scripture that I ain't been able to get away from for several weeks. It's found right up here this morning. I'm going to read it to you. That and she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room found for them in the end. Amen. Now I know this ain't going to be popular preaching this morning, but church, if we're going to serve God, we have got to make room for Him this morning. We're living in a fast-paced society that does not have time for God. It does not have time for the Word of God. It does not have time for the fellow man around Him. It does not have time to stop and pray this morning. But if people. Can you imagine what God thought when he sent Mary and Joseph back to Bethlehem? Ma'am, sir, I've got the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings is to be delivered soon. My wife's expecting the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings. Have you got any room? No room here. Shut the door. Next door. The Lord needs in. You got any room for him? You remember that morning, Brother Sam, when the Lord come by your heart?
Yeah. Amen.
I need a place to stay. Amen.
Amen.
Bible said that the foxes have holes and the birds have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head. I'll not tell you why, because he does not lay his head upon an earthly pillow, but it is to be laid upon our hearts daily. Amen. I want you to know this morning that there was a knock, no doubt, rang out all across Bethlehem. Let me tell you something, men. I know there's a lot of fathers here in the house. How many of you, Brother Sam, when your wife was expecting that little one to come, you weren't really excited about carrying her down to the barn, was you? Amen. But you wanted to provide the very best you could for them today. I want you to know this morning, God expects the best this morning, but he was willing and humble this morning to take the lowest position in that town. And tell me we ain't got a God of humility.
Come on.
Amen.
Amen.
Now let me tell you what the Bible said about us. He said, humble yourself, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time. You see, somebody comes by and thumps us, and we blow up like you thump a bullfrog on the nose. When somebody don't go just your way, what do? We won't puff up. That's just the human nature in us. But that's not the Christ that I know in Christmas.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
If y'all know just how much the world loves and serves one another, go down to Walmart on Black Friday. Amen. No, thank you. Good word, Sam. Oh, I ain't never been there and I don't want to be there. But I've seen little evidence of it. When that lady cuts you off in the aisle and grabs that last toy that you had planned for Susie. Amen. That last Barbie doll set is gone. What did you think? Amen. I'm going to get down to where we're living. Amen. But if we serve one another, amen, what are we going to do? I'm talking about making room for Jesus this morning. What I'm trying to say is we're living in an imperfect world. And if we are going to have an impact upon them, instead of wanting to call them whatever kind of dog you think about them, why don't you look at them and say, well, I've got the Lord, I'm blessed, maybe they don't, let's pray for them.
Amen.
How about pull them over to the side and ask them if you can pray for them and share the love of Jesus about them, because they might not know about him. Reckon, I want you to know this morning, the true gospel is not being preached and taught in the world in which we live in, but we have got to make room for that knock, a man upon our heart, the prompting of the Holy Spirit to step in and speak to that person. It has got to be a yielding, a making room, or making time for God this morning if we're going to serve him. Brother Sam, if me and you never made any time to get in this book, what would the church be like? I don't think it'd be any lights burning this morning. I'm being honest with you. Or they'd done found them another pastor one. Amen. If I don't make time to get on my knees before the Lord and ask Him what He wants for my life, what He wants out of that Word of God, if I don't spend time with Him and ask Him how He wants me to carry out my life, reveal unto me the way He'd have me to live, how would I live? Just like the heathen down the street. Church, if you want to have an impact, if you want to have a good Christmas, make time and place for Christ.
Amen.
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 There was no room found in the inn. We know what that meant. They call it Day's Inn up the street. What about the I-N? Within. That's the inn that I want to talk about this morning. That's the inn that I've been talking about this morning. Making room in. Within. Have you made room in your heart for Him within? Let me tell you, you're going to have to throw some stuff out. Let me back up and rephrase that. You're not going to have to. You're going to want to. You might say, how is that, preacher? Let me tell you something. Before you ever let Him in, you're going to see who you are. Brother Sam, don't ever be afraid to preach to them who they are. The world's putting pressure on you not to. I'm thankful for a man of God that told me who I was and where I was going. Amen? Until we see true to true who we are, there's no hope. But Brother Sam, when I seen who I was, lost, undone, wretched, every intent in my heart was not pure. Might have been somewhat good, but not pure. Amen? I cannot produce purity within myself. You know, they make these things now that you can pour that dirty water in and it's called a filtration system and it's supposed to make pure water. Kind of got an odd flavor to it, don't it? Y'all may not know what I'm talking about because I've went down to the spring where the pure stuff's run out. I'm still old-fashioned. I've been there. That's what they call sweet water. It's soothing. I've had some of it. A lot of you children ain't got a clue. I'm just going to be honest with you. You don't. Y'all spoilt on Perrier water. Let me tell you something. You're satisfied with it, ain't we? How many of y'all still got up this morning and drawed a bucket of water? I didn't. We're satisfied with it. I'm down to where we're at this morning, church. We don't have room for the real thing anymore. Y'all remember them old grannies and grandpas? The Word of God would get on them. The Holy Spirit would come by and they'd get up and go to shouting and running across. I think we still got a little bit of it sitting around in here.
Yeah.
Amen?
Amen?
I've seen some of it in action around here. You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
But the question is, are you willing to go down to the spring where she got it and get it yourself? Or are you still satisfied stuck on Perrier water this morning? Amen. I want you to know this morning how the world the world can dress it up and can make it pretty good. Amen. They can satisfy you with it if you're willing to be. But the real stuff has got to be dug out and it's got to have some time to clear up, my friend. And you've got to dig it out and let the Holy Spirit reveal it unto you. And you got to be willing to drink it.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
You see, a lot of us have got what? We got the head knowledge. I ain't trying to be funny this morning. We stuff it in. We stuff it in. Some of us parents, we try to beat it into our kids, don't we? That's all right. your kids has got a drug problem on Sunday morning, that'll be all right, drag them on out here. One feller said, I had a drug problem growing up, said my mama drugged me to church every time the doors was open. That'll be the best kind of problem they'll ever have. Amen?
Amen. Come on.
But children, there's coming a time and a day when you have got to make the decision whether you want it or not. I'm talking about eternal life this morning. I'm talking about a relationship with God Almighty. I'm talking about a steadfast peace. Steadfast peace and joy this morning. Which day was it the Lord gave you joy? I couldn't keep up with them all. But I know the one that He gave me joy. Amen. I remember that morning to this day. I don't think I'll ever forget it. And let me tell you something, no church, about how to have joy. What's the first letter in the word joy? You reckon that would stand for Jesus?
Amen.
What's the next one? What do you think that ought to stand for? Others. What's the next one? What do you think that stands for?
You.
You. Jesus, others, and then you. Church, if you want to have real Christmas, you put Jesus first.
Amen.
Others second, and then you. Amen. The Bible teaches me to esteem my brother higher than myself. That's the heart of Christmas this morning. That's the heart of God this morning. He sent Jesus first. He put Himself, amen, on the back burner that day. You don't believe me, do you? Because He stepped aside and saw His Son hang on the cross of Calvary so that He could have a relationship with you. That's how much God loves you. Why? Because you and yourself, if you tried to fix it, was going to end up in a place called hell if you don't accept the Lord this morning. Jesus, others, and you. Have you prepared any room in your heart this day for the Lord to work? That's my question. Have you opened your heart if the Lord come by and knocked? He's going to walk by every bench this morning. You might say, preacher, I'm up on the front line. You are. You telling me you perfect yet? You know what, Brother Sam? I see a lot of Christians this morning. Let me tell you something. Me and you ain't as close to the far as we can get. You know where we need to be? Right up there in that altar. Getting a little bit more. Let me tell you something, church. The Lord don't come by and offer you a drink for nothing. But tomorrow, when the sun gets high, and you're in the valley where there ain't no water, you're going to wish you'd have drunk. Amen? I've been through them. Been times that the Lord offered me and I was too busy. Been time, Brother Sam, He'd give me a thought. I was too busy. I wouldn't open it up. I'd go on with my life. Before the week is out, as we were digging.
Amen.
Because I done got in the valley. But let me tell you something. When the Lord comes by, it's time to go. It's time to go. He said, my spirit, brother, will not always strive with man. Amen. We heard that in Sunday school this morning. It is good. The gift cannot be received unless it is offered this morning. Will you this morning, if you're here and you're lost, receive the gift of salvation through Jesus Christ this morning? If He's offered it unto you, would you receive it? Would you accept it? That's the question this morning. Will you make room within your heart for Jesus? Maybe you're tired of living the disappointment. Smile all you want to. The disappointments that's been in your life. Maybe you're tired of wondering what's next. Maybe you're tired not having any real assurance. I talked to a man not long ago. He was from a different religion. But I said, how do you get to heaven? You know what he finally just basically told me? I don't know. He's older than you, Sam.
Young man.
A lot older than you, Sam. I don't know exactly how old he was. At the end of the day, when I got through, when a little time I got to spend with him, there was no real assurance in the man's life. Let me tell you something. I can stand here today and tell you that if I walk out those doors and you never see me again, look for me in heaven.
Amen.
Why? Because the blood of Jesus has been applied to my heart.
Amen.
And I don't have anything to plead, but I've got the blood.
Amen.
Amen. And that's all I need this morning when I go before the throne of God is the blood of Jesus Christ. It's the only thing that'll work this morning is when we plead the blood. We don't have anything. What does the old song say? No prize I bring, simply to thy cross I cling. Amen. That's the only hope I've got this morning. Why? Because it's the only sacrifice that's ever been and it'll ever be that was worthy and worth and would quench the wrath of God this morning. There is no other way. The Bible said no other name given among men whereby we must be saved this morning but the name of Jesus Christ. We must plead the blood this morning.
Amen.
Is there any room within? Is there any room within? I can just hear Joseph knocking on the door. Is there any room within? Next one. Is there any room within? Is there any room? Church, is there any room? Amen. Is there any room? Somebody give us a song of an invitation this morning. I'm going to be brief. Is there any room? Is there any room? I don't know your heart this morning, but I know what the Lord put on mine, and I've never seen Him wrong. There's somebody here that needs to just open up their heart and say, as that song that I said says, no prize I bring, but simply to thy cross I cling. Let me tell you something. The most joy you'll ever have is that day.
Amen.
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 You told me about that sweet gum down there on the side of the pasture. Pretty hard to uproot, wasn't it? Let me tell you something. The devil ain't got no log skidders for God's people. We'll sink our roots like that old sweet gum did. We'll be like that tree the Bible said that's planted by the rivers, the waters of life. We shall not be moved. Shall not be moved. If you just open up your heart this morning and let Him come in, He'll be an anchor in your life that the storms of this life will never move. If you just open up. If you just open up your heart and say, Lord, here am I. Would you stand with us, please? Sam, come stand with us if you would. I want to give you an opportunity. This altar, I hope, has never been closed. But I want to invite you to come and just open up to the Lord. Whatever your troubles may be, bring it to the Lord this morning. Make room for Jesus this morning. Church, you want to be more effective in the coming year? Make more room for Jesus. If you want to see more souls walk this aisle, make more room for Jesus. Would you come? Would you come?
I want to sing this song for you.
The sound.
Goes like this, a fourth, a fifth, a minor fall, the major lift with every breath I'm singing, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Bethlehem, expecting child, they searched the inn to find a place where you were coming soon. There was no room for them to stay, so in a manger filled with hay, God's only son was born. Oh, left their flocks by night to see this baby wrapped in light. A host of angels led them all to you.
Can you hear?
It was just as the angels said, you'll find him in a manger bed. Place at which you were, the frankincense and gold and myrrh they gave to you and cried out, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Baby boy would grow to be a man and one day die for you and me. my sins would drive the nails in you. That rugged cross was my cross too. Still, every breath you drew was hallelujah. 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 This baby boy has come to earth to bring us joy, and I just wanna sing this song to you. It goes like this: a fourth, a fifth, a minor fall, the major lift with every breath I'm singing. Bethlehem, expecting child, they searched the inn to find a place, for you were coming soon. There was no room for them to stay, so in a manger filled with hay, God's only son was born. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Left their flocks by night to see this baby wrapped in light. A host of angels led them all to you. It was just as the angel said, you'll find him in a manger bed. Emmanuel and Savior, hallelujah. In the east to Bethlehem, the wise men three came many miles and journey long for you. Into the place at which you were, the frankincense and gold and myrrh they gave to you in Christ.
When you come to history, amen.
And I hope that you've enjoyed as much as I have. I get happy when the Lord's in the house. Amen. And he's been in the house. Amen. I can feel it. And no matter what our problems may be, God can help us. God can help us. I love him this day. Any announcements before we dismiss?
Yes, Sam, I'd like to say real quick to all the youth and the musicians up here, thank you all out, guys, for participating in that. Certainly do appreciate it.
Hey, man, let's give them a big hand. I certainly enjoy it. Amen. And did you see they all had a choice and had something to do, even from my little bitty granddaughter, all of them. Did you notice they hit them on cue? Amen. Oh, I was tickled to death. It's wonderful what God can do, isn't it? Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Let's continue to thank God for his love and his mercy and his blessing, the joy of God in our life. Any other announcements? Yes, we do. Don't miss next Sunday either. And Brother Gary is done with lights. Okay? You'll like it. I'll give that much away. I even helped with some of the props. I helped, see there? I get to find something. Me. Any other announcements?